in any electoral process such as this, a candidate will be declared elected, but all of us are winners.
Congratulations.
The president-elect of the Nigerian Bar Association, Senior Advocate of Nigeria, A.B. Mahmood, asks lawyers to unite and work together to build a brave new bar, a bar to be run on the core values of integrity and ethical lawyering, a bar that will be driven by the knowledge and skills of its members as a veritable agent for national transformation. Also on the program, we bring you some of the early reactions trailing the emergence of A.B. Mahmood as president-elect. His challenger, J.K. Gadzama, has rejected the results of the elections and called for fresh, credible electronic and not internet elections. The Electoral Committee Chairman, Kenneth Mosier, SAN, in an exclusive interview with Law Weekly, explains how the committee did its work and measures put in place to guarantee a transparent outcome. Hello and welcome to the program. I am Shola Shuyeli. Now, it's no longer news that the Nigerian Bar Association has a president-elect. Voting for the elections opened at midnight on the 30th of July and closed at 11:59 p.m. on the 31st. After the close of polls, the Situation Room at the NBA Secretariat in Abuja was thrown open to the leadership of the bar and journalists to witness the announcement of results. Before the announcement, however, some independent observers would monitor the elections, check the integrity of the process, and verify the conduct and the outcome of the polls. Then the chairman of the Electoral Committee read out the winners.
General Secretary Yama Desmond, 2,510 votes. Olagunju Isiaka, 2,721 votes. Having scored the higher number of votes, is declared, is elected, and is the winner, and is declared elected. Third Vice President Oji Benedict is unopposed, the winner. Second Vice President Ubani Monde is unopposed. First Vice President Dajan Caleb Gal is also unopposed. The scores are there. And for the President, Gadzama Joe Kiari, SAN, 2,384 votes. Mahmood Abubakar Balarabe, SAN, 3,055 votes, scored the higher number of votes, is the winner, and is hereby declared elected. Gentlemen, that is the result of the election, but I want to admonish us to appreciate that there are a lot of apprehension sometimes for new things, but we must remain focused and we'll keep our eye on the ball. And the idea is to build a credible electoral database for the bar. Tomorrow we can develop on it. If you have any suggestions, it should be of a positive kind and not necessarily one meant to pull down the system. So I want to thank you for the confidence reposed in us. I want to thank the candidates also for submitting themselves to this process.
The president of the bar is happy. He believes that a good foundation has been laid for improving on the electoral process.
The work that your committee has done has set a foundation for the NBA to gravitate to a level that other associations, and I keep begging INEC, they should come and borrow our system to use for national elections. The most significant cost we have incurred has been in legal fees to defend the action filed. That has been the most significant, am I right? The most significant line item. And you will see it at the neck when we give you state of account. The success of this process is not due entirely to the committee or to the national executive officers, but due to the cooperation and collaboration of all members of the association. Firstly, who agreed to pass the constitutional amendment for universal suffrage, who agreed to pass the constitutional amendment for e-voting, and I give glory to God that majority of our lawyers are very happy with the transition process. Yes. And the result of those who have been returned can clearly be seen to be the outcome of a transparent process. There's one position, and 10 people might be going for that position, but only one person will get it.
Yes.
And if we all understand that, then there will be no reason to descend to the levels that some particular person descended to in this election. But as I've said, we will address all the issues frontally. If the last 25 days I'm going to spend here is to try and clear up any other issues that fell out from the elections, any misdemeanors, missteps, we will do it. So that going forward, what the new president will meet will be a better workable system.
Having been notified by his agents of the outcome, the president-elect walked in shortly after the announcement of results to the admiration of his supporters here.
Yes, please move.
Congratulations.
He then gives his acceptance speech.
In any electoral process such as this, a candidate will be declared elected, but all of us are winners. Those who participated as candidates for the various positions, those of us who voted as members of the association, the distinguished colleagues who ran the process, the very special assistants that have run the technical side of the process, and all the campaign people and all the teams, very distinguished able lieutenants all across the country. We're all winners. Our association is the better for it. And I'd like to seize the opportunity to congratulate all of us for participating in this very unique process that has produced probably the first major election in this country based purely on electronic platform. I think this is a trailblazer, and I would like to commend the president for his foresight, for his innovation. I'd like to commend the technology providers for this trailblazing innovation, and I'd like to commend all of us who have painstakingly participated in this process. So I thank you, all of you, and I hope that this will be the end of all controversies and acrimonies, and let us move forward as a united bar. The rest of the country is watching us, and I'm sure that they have a lot to learn from us positively from the outcome of this election. So I urge all of our colleagues to put their heads together and let us move as a united bar association and achieve the vision that our founders have set for ourselves to be among the foremost bar associations across the world. So I wish to humbly accept this challenge and to thank God for seeing us through the entire election. All of us on all the teams on all sides have traveled across the country, and thankfully there's not been any incident. We've not had any mishap. So we have to give glory to God. Those of us who have not probably achieved the outcome that was desired, urge them to unite with us to really move forward and to put all that has happened behind us. Mr. President, thank you very much and congratulations for this wonderful initiative. Chairman, Electoral Body, thank you so much for your painstaking effort and for all the sacrifices that all of you have made. We will go back. As you said, sir, you have 25 more days. And I assure you that we'll go back, do the thinking between now and the 25 days, and we'll certainly, God willing, hit the ground running after the formal inauguration. It's very early in the morning, so I don't want to keep you waiting. I'm sure we've had a very long and tiring day, but I'd just like to say thank you, and God bless.